Hey guys, Thunder E here, and welcome to our 2018 Ultimate Holiday Gift Guide. Now, there are a lot of deals out there. Black Friday is around the corner, and you're thinking, what should I buy? Well, here are some of the things I think you should go ahead and pick up this holiday season that are worth it in terms of value, price, and also just great gifts for loved ones. Now, if you want to go ahead and support us at Border Work, definitely use our Amazon link down below. It's not going to cost you anything. You've got one central link and it has all the products there for you to check out. So let's not waste any time and start off with our first set of products. So starting off with headphones, we're taking a look at the Tunai drums. I consider this probably one of the best cost-effective in-ear buds to buy at $32.99. You really can't go wrong with them. They do pack in some bass there, so if you're a bass fan, you will be right at home with these headphones. And they are really nice, really lovely tin case, simple form factor, clear drivers, and I think you definitely like them. Now, if you're looking for something for the sports-minded individual, then the Backbeat Fit 3100 from Plantronics is really what you should look at. Now, there are a ton of sports and fitness headphones. This do not do any tracking activity, but I do like the fit and comfort for them. Also, the way they rest in your ear, so while you're working out, you can actually do all the activities you want to do with ease, and also you can hear some of your surroundings. Audio quality is really good. The driver is really pushing in. I think they're about 7mm drivers, and something you should definitely use when you're working out with these pair of headphones. Now, of course, if you're looking for noise canceling headphones, nothing better than the Sony WH-1000 Mark IIIs. At $349, you can't go wrong with these. Probably one of the best sounds in the category. Clean, clear, crisp. The only way you want to listen to music is with these. Now, moving forward to gaming, there's only one headphone that I say that you really want to pick up to enjoy your gaming experience. I'm talking about the Actus Pro from SteelSeries, priced at $228 with the Game DAC. This is probably one of the most all-rounded gaming headphones I've used this year. Great solid pop-out mic. Of course, you've got RGB colors in the headphones. The DAC itself gives you high-def audio as well, high-res audio, sorry. So you've got clean, crisp sound that can be beat by any other headphones out there. So now moving over to cameras, we've got one that I think for anyone who's looking to pick up a camera that does really solid photos, but also really good video at 4K. You gotta look at the RX 100 Mark V. These came out last year, but they're really, really good. Now priced at $898, you can't go wrong with them. They are a go-to nice point and shoot. There's nothing like this on the market right now, and I think it's really handy. Now, if you wanna use this to vlog, or you're thinking about, hey, jumping up on YouTube, and you want a dedicated camera, this is pretty good. And using, also picking up the Sony VT camera grip for vlogging. It's a very simple camera grip. It doesn't have an extended length, but it's a nice place on a table. You can hold it, and it's got a functionality to actually take photos and record directly from it. Simple, it's easy, it's about $99. And of course, you need storage for your camera. And I definitely suggest the Kingston Canvas React SD card or micro SD, either one. A 256 variant goes for about $74, is what I use. I really like it. It's fast responsive, 100 megabits per second read, 90 megabits per second write. So that's pretty much high up there for your camera needs. Now, moving over to laptops. There have been a lot of laptops this year, but I think if you're looking for a clean, sleek Ultrabook, you gotta go with the Huawei Mate Pro X. Came out early in the year, but this thing is still a stunner. It's got the 8th generation Intel Core processor, or Core i5, Core i7. It's priced at $1,499. You can get up to 16 gigs of RAM. You've also got the ability of a built-in GTX MX150 card, so you can do some editing and some more work with this thing. It's super light, has USB Type-C ports on there as well, a headphone jack, a Windows Hello functionality. This thing is a nice, sleek, and very functional Ultrabook to pick up, and I think that's one a lot of people should gravitate to in this holiday season. Now, if you're looking for something with some gaming power, but you don't want to spend a lot of money, and I think probably the best all-rounder in terms of gaming laptops, I gotta go with the Razer Blade 15 Base. The base model here, compared to the higher models, has a 60 hertz refresh rate display on there. This thing comes with 128 gigabytes of storage. It's got also 1 terabyte of extra storage as well. It's a Core i7, it's the 8th generation in there, and you've got a GTX 1060 on there. So it's really good. Plus, it's upgradable. You could open it up and swap out either the standard hard drive or the NVMe, and you are good to go, and also increase your RAM. So this thing is upgradable, and it starts off at a low price point that you can't go wrong as a gamer to definitely use and pick up. Now, speaking of accessories here, the couple that I want to actually point out. First off is the Kingston USB-C Nucleum dongle. Now, USB-C, of course, is a new standard, and say you pick up that Huawei MateBook Pro X, or even say the new MacBook Air or new iPad Pro, you're going to be using a USB-C dongle, and there are a lot of them that are quite expensive. The Nucleum is about $49. It's got two extra USB-C Type-C ports. It's also got a port for a micro SD card reader, a full USB, HDMI out, so all that built into it to power and fulfill all your functionalities all the way through. I really like it. I like what it actually does as a USB Type-C dock there. Now, if you're looking for, of course, charging, there's one I actually want to bring up to you. It's the Altigo portable charger. It's a 20,100 milliamp charger for $44. Comes in with different variants. You've got connectors for either micro USB, Lightning, or USB, depends on whichever one you want to pick up and buy. But it's got a good charging there. You can, of course, recharge it at 20,000 milliamps, you can't go wrong. And I think it's just nice, simple, and easy to pick up. Now, if you want something that has more charging functionality, the Morphe Power Station USB-C, it's at $149. What I like about it is the fact that it can go ahead and fully recharge that Huawei MateBook Pro X. I like it for that functionality. I think there are very few chargers out there that can do that. So this is something definitely worth picking up for your accessory needs. Now, speaking of TVs, you can't go wrong with anything from the QLED lineup from Samsung. Whether you're starting off at the more cost-effective Q6FN or going up to the premium Q9FN, you really can't go wrong with vibrant colors, really sharp, fast refresh rates, of course, great visual quality there. Gaming looks fantastic on it. Videos look fantastic on this thing. As also the menu system and all the apps that's built in is truly one of the best TV sets to pick up, and I think it's definitely worth it. Now, if you've got a budget and you want to get something a little bit more for your pocket size, I would say the TCL 6 series does not disappoint. For the 55 inch at $629, this thing is an absolute steal in terms of television sets. Of course, it's got Roku power built in there. You've also got HDR10 support, as well as Dolby Atmos. Plus, it can handle games quite well on this TV set. I think it's really, really, really solid. Now, when it comes to audio, you're looking at the Sonos Beam at $399. This is probably one of the best soundbars on the market. Of course, you've got that true premium Sonos sound. You've got a small form factor. It's got, of course, ARC support built in there for you. Plus, you can pair it with your other Sonos speakers, and I think it goes a long way. I forgot to mention the price range, of course, for that TCL TV is $629. Now, moving over to smartwatches, of course, I got to talk about two very distinct and different smartwatches. First off is the Galaxy Watch 2. I think probably right now it's probably one of the best smartwatches on the market. It's got really good battery life. You can get up to about 4 days of battery life on this thing and still go to the gym, do your activity tracking and things like that. Beautiful watch faces, you can change the watch bands as well. It's a really nice functional watch that of course will work with any of your Android devices as well as iOS. Now, if you're looking for something not maybe too technical, you can go with the Chronobee hybrid smartwatch. Chronobee makes some really stylish smartwatches here. This is of course a watch that looks like a wristwatch. Pricing starts from about $700. It's got of course the functionality built in to control with using the different knobs or dials, so you can take photos, you can mark your location, you can of course get notifications via vibration. But the cool thing about it is the battery life is 2 years on this device, so that is actually nice. Plus, it looks like a timeless timepiece.
Now let's go ahead and round it up. Of course, the category that a lot of people are concerned about and thinking, smartphones. What smartphone to get? And I've got a couple of smartphones. I mean, there are many smartphones there on the market, but I'll start off with the OnePlus 6T. I think this is probably one of the best buys for the holiday. You've got, of course, various colors. You can buy it directly from OnePlus, T-Mobile. They've got the Midnight Black, they've got the Mirror Black, and they've got the Thunder Purple. So the thing looks really beautiful. It's got the performance of a high-end smartphone, the pricing of a mid-tier, and I think you can't go wrong. Plus, it will work on your T-Mobile and Verizon, T-Mobile, AT&T, and Verizon. So you've got at least most of the carrier functionality covered with this device right here. Now, there are many other devices to pick from in terms of high-end devices, and if you're looking for something with high-end capabilities and you want to basically, get something nice for holidays, I say you should go with the Galaxy S9 or S9 Plus. I think you would definitely love it there. Came out much earlier in the year. Spec-wise, it still matches everything that's out there currently on the market. But you've got, of course, all that full premium Samsung finish. I think pricing now says about $600 and something. Of course, in the holiday, you're getting a very good deal. And if you're an iOS user, you're wondering which iPhone should I go ahead and pick up, my recommendation is the iPhone XR. I think this is the best bang for your buck here at a price of about $799. You've got the best battery performance of any iPhone out there on the market. You've got, of course, the full functionality of all that with the A12 Bionic chipset. And you've got a really good camera on there as well. So you've got everything you need without spending up to $1,000 on your device. So there you have it, guys.
So guys, hopefully this helped you out with your holiday. We'll be doing different gift guides, so you can definitely check out some more specific things here and there. But definitely use the link down below, as I mentioned. If you have any questions or any comments, or there's something I didn't cover you're looking for, go ahead and ask that question down below and I'll try and answer them for you. And if you're watching us for the first time, please hit the subscribe button. And if you haven't done that already, also hit the notification bell to be notified with our latest videos. It's Thunder E here saying thank you and always enjoy your entertainment.